Hello, Ron Roddy here at Klebstech, and today I have a video on a feature of Focus that I'm trying to learn, multi-line prompts and blending. If you're not familiar with Focus, it is a great, easy to use and learn interface for Stable Diffusion and something I think everyone should have in their AI toolbox. I do have plenty of other videos on Focus that goes into all aspects of using it if you have any interest. Now on to today's topic, multi-line prompts. Now this is supposed to be similar to the multi-prompt feature in Midjourney, but in practice seems a little bit different. I have not been able to find much information online about this feature in Focus, so I've been doing a lot of experimenting. And I'm hoping that if anybody else is out there, if I spread this, maybe people will figure out a better way or how well it works and can provide some more information in the comments. The idea behind a multi-line prompt, you type in your prompt, hit enter, and type in another prompt. Then from my understanding, as it generates, it alternates between the two as it's generating these. The thing is, if you just put in a cat, a dog, or something like that, I find it doesn't work very well. The other thing is when you're doing this, I also find it's better to turn off styles. We'll go ahead and do that because remember, those do add to your prompts and the Focus V2 would change it each time. So you're definitely gonna wanna avoid that. The other thing is you wanna preferably stay on one seed and work with one seed, because as you keep adjusting, each seed is going to be different on where that merge point is, where these two will merge. So that's the challenge, is finding where that point is when you're working on it. What I have discovered is that you want to use weights. Let's start off with people first. So I've got my styles turned off. I have set to just a regular seed. I've turned off random. Now in here, I have a photo of Robert De Niro and a painting of Emma Watson. You can mix and match, it can be a photo of each. I find if you add a little bit more to each one, it seems to work better. So if you just had Robert De Niro and Emma Watson, it doesn't seem to work as well. I haven't done enough extensive testing to verify one way or the other. The big thing is prompt weights. Now the way prompt weights work, if you're not familiar, is you click on a word or highlight a phrase, and then you can use control up and down arrow, and that'll add these weights. Now, if it's 1.1, that's a more weight. If it's under one, so 0.8, that's lower than one. So for these, I usually find it's good to start somewhere in the 0.5 or 0.6, and then you start adjusting them depending on the results that you get. Also, I find it works better with quality settings. This is more steps, so I think there's more room for it to blend these things two together. People are a lot easier than other things. So that's why I'm starting off with people to show you this. Now, usually I will put less weight on the first one to start. By default, that first line seems to have the heavier weight. Let's go ahead, we'll hit generate. Now, the first thing I do when I'm doing this is, like I said, you gotta find, if you watch, you'll see it's kind of alternating between the two. And then it kind of grasps onto one as the predominant one. When you're blending people, I find you don't have to necessarily adjust these numbers quite as much, because they're people, they're similar objects, so they blend much better than other things will. So we have our first blend. Now at this point, I'd say, well, I want it to be more of like De Niro. So I'll increase the weight on De Niro. I won't touch the weight on Emma Watson. I'll hit generate again. Now, if I had it on random, this probably wouldn't work that well, because like I said, every seed seems to be different. So you gotta stick with one seed when you're trying to merge these. And as we can see, as it's generating, it's alternating between the two. And then we'll increase it a little bit more. Now on that one, I might say, well, that went a little too far what I wanted to do. So at this point, we knew that 0.6 wasn't what I wanted. 0.7 seems to go too far the other way. So now I can put 0.65. So that's about halfway between the 0.6 and the 0.7. Let's pull up some of these images just so we can take a look at these. So this is the first one we did. And then we did the second one, the third one, which went too far. And then we went back and we got the one somewhere in the middle. So that's pretty simple. When it comes to people, it's actually not that difficult. You just keep tweaking these numbers, and you can even go down to 3 or 4 decimal places. I mean, to fine tune exactly what you're looking for, get that exact look that you're looking for. This won't carry over between each seed. If we were to actually go in and let's change this to a random seed. And now if we look at those two, obviously the blending is different. Not drastically, but it is different. So far in my testing, people is pretty easy to merge. It does take a little bit of tweaking to get the exact results that you're looking for. Now, if we go over to merging animals and people, then that gets a little bit more difficult. So for this example, we're gonna just start off with photo of Marilyn Monroe. Now, sometimes it's useful to find, if you're trying to find a good shot, is start off, find, you know, the image that you're looking for, and then you can work from there. So on this one, if we were just to put in a photo of Marilyn Monroe, this is the result we're gonna get from this seed. The problem with merging people and animals, you can't just put in, if we wanna merge her with a cat, if you put in a cat on the next line, it's probably not gonna work well because they're so vastly different. So what I found is it's actually a little bit easier if you wanna do it this way. So let's go ahead, I'm gonna remove that one initially. Let's just put in what we're gonna use for the other prompt just to see what we get for a result. So I use, instead of just cat, I use an anthropomorphic cat, which means that they have traits of people. It means they stand upright, two legs, two arms, hands, things like that. So you're more likely to get better results by using that when you're merging it with a person. So these are our two results from using each one of those prompts. But by using the multi-line prompt, we can now see how these two will merge. And we'll start these off at both 0.5 just to see how those come out. I find those are good starting points. And some of these come out really weird. So we got that on our first try. Sometimes it takes a little more finesse. Now, if I wanted to weight one of these more than the other, then I can increase that, obviously. So for here, I'm gonna increase that to 0.55. I like to do, I don't like to go like 0.5 to 0.6 because those seem to be pretty drastic changes. Once you figure out where that blend works pretty well, I find usually going down to the second decimal point gives you a greater ability to fine tune it. Okay, now let's try it at 0.6 so we can see the difference between the 0.5, 0.55 and 0.6. Okay, so our initial one is here on the right. The two on the left are pretty close, the one on the right isn't. So that's where you can start fine tuning and adjusting those numbers to get the results that you're looking for. Now, sometimes you're gonna get some really weird results out of these. This was Mr. T and a turtle. Definitely didn't look like Mr. T and a turtle. For example, here we have Emma Watson as a cat, and we have Clint Eastwood as an eagle. So that gives you an idea of how the people and animals work. Like I said, if you just put cat in here, you'd have an actual difficult time. I did get it to succeed sometimes on some of these, but it was extremely difficult to accomplish that because the images were just so vastly different. It couldn't find an easy way to blend them. Now, the other thing you can do is blending multiple animals. So for this one, we have everything turned off. And I have a photo of a frog and a photo of a spider. Decrease the weights on these a little bit. And just let's see how these come out. Now, in my experimentation, not all animals can be easily merged together. If they're drastically different, you're gonna have much of a harder time finding that sweet spot. And they might not come out as you expect either. So for this one, I can already see it's coming out pretty much as a frog. So I'm gonna go ahead and stop that. I'm gonna lower the weight on that frog to 0.6 and we'll see how that goes. So now that one looks a little too much like a spider for me. So at this point, if I want something in between, I'm gonna change that to 0.65. So we know 0.7 was more frog, 0.6 was more spider. So hopefully we're somewhere in the middle, we're gonna get that spider frog. And there we go, spider frog. That works pretty well. I've covered merging people, people and animals, animals and animals. Plenty of other things that you can merge as well. I haven't even experimented with that many, but you could easily, let's say, a photo of an apple and a pineapple. Go ahead and generate those. And we have our pineapple. I don't know what you call that. Pineapple's already got apple in the name. Well, that's pretty much all I have so far on this feature, but I'll continue to experiment. If you have any tips on using multi-line prompts in Focus, please leave a comment. If you found the video helpful, please consider hitting the like button. And if you want to buy me a coffee, there is a link in the description. Thanks for watching and have a great day.